Some kids grow up liking baseball or football, and they worship those guys. I wasn't one of those kids. I grew up in a house that had art, original art, all over the place. My dad was a sculptor, my mom owned a gallery, and so I tuned into the art thing. That became my foundation, my identity. So the fact that I can pick up a brush, I feel like I'm part of that brotherhood of all of those painters that picked up a brush and went outside. You know, like, I know Monet, I know Van Gogh, I know they swatted mosquitoes just like I've swatted mosquitoes and picked them out of the canvas. And yeah, so I feel excited about that, you know. So that's what turns me on about it, is that it's... you know, I'm following in the footsteps of these heroes that I like a lot. And if I can add to the history of art, if somehow I could be lucky enough to do something original that matters, then that would be, you know, a good thing for me. So, what makes a piece of art count or matter? What makes it important? I'm beginning to think that it is based on the stuff that's in here, inside the artist, that comes out, that's original. Maybe the technique that you're using is original. And then the impact on the audience. You know, if they're moved by it, or if they feel excited about it, or if they're challenged by it, then you're on to something. In my art career, this door of what to do with the things that you make has been opening up over the years, right? So when I first started painting, I painted anything. And I was so excited that I could make, you know, a rowboat look like a rowboat on the canvas. But as I've been doing this more and more, what I realized that the exciting stuff is the original stuff, the stuff that no one has ever seen before or no one would have considered doing before, except for you, that artist. Because of your originality, you gave the world something that is, you know, new. This is the best job in the world for me. It might not be for anybody else, but for me, it has been terrific. I have said to people that if I were to drop dead tomorrow, that having had the chance to do this is pretty cool. Like, I think I'm pretty lucky to have experienced this full-time art job. And it's good for me because I'm my own boss. I get to commune with nature. I get to create something that's never been created before and share it with the world. I don't know. I don't think I could do anything else, actually, to give me that much happiness. You know, when you follow your heart, when you really do what you feel you were meant to be doing, the universe sort of opens up and paths reveal themselves to you. And it works, you know, for me, not only in the business aspect of being an artist and successfully making sales, but in the aspect of me growing as a person. This path that I'm on, this art path, it's so nice. It's so exciting and educational, and I meet wonderful people and I end up in wonderful places. It's much different than the cubicle that I used to work in, I have to say.